Hi again everybody to my second video of the series of designing non-circular convex gears. In this video, we are going to dive into some important concepts for understanding the design principles of involute gears, both circular and non-circular. Also, we are going to see the differences in terms of the function and the design, as well as other important definitions. The numerical design methodology will be presented briefly, as well as the expected results of the experimental test on the prepared test rig. As it is well known, the main objective of the circular gears is to transmit torque and speed to another engaged member with a fixed transmission ratio. While for non-circular gears, the main objective is speed ratio variation. In another word, non-circular gears speed ratio fluctuates in every single cycle of the gear set for achieving the required specific movement in a device or a machine. It is intuitive to note that the radius of non-circular gears is variable while it is constant in the case of circular gears. Moreover, it may be surprising to say that circular gears are considered a special case of non-circular ones. In non-circular gears, the same used terminologies in circular gears are used as module or diametrical pitch, addendum, dedendum, and base curve. Also, the design of circular gear can be reduced to designing just one single tooth, as all the teeth are identical, and even designing one side of one tooth. The tooth right and left profiles are symmetric. However, this way cannot be applied in the case of non-circular gear. Rather, the profiles of each tooth must be generated separately, as they are often not identical, and even the left and right sides of one tooth are mostly not symmetric. Here we are seeing the output of the MATLAB code for logarithmic gear, where the teeth are not identical. One important point should not be overlooked. In circular gears, any tooth from the pinion can mesh correctly with any space of the gear, and vice versa. While in the case of non-circular gears, each tooth of the pinion has a specific corresponding space of the gear to mesh with, and it cannot mesh with the other spaces mostly. As it was shown in the first video, the equations describe the relationship between the synthroids are as the following. The summation of the radius of the first gear and the second gear also will form the center distance, where both R1 and R2 are function to θ1, while the speed ratio equation will be as shown here. From equations 2 and 1, we can conclude the pitch curve equations. Also, the angle of rotation of the second synthroid can be obtained. It can be noted easily that these previous equations still valid even for circular gears. Two important concepts have a major role in non-circular gears design, which are involute and evolute curves. The evolute of a curve is defined as the summation of all the center of rotation points of the curve's points. Equally, it is the envelope of the normals to the curve. The involute of a curve is a curve that, with respect to it, the given curve is considered its evolute. In other words, we can imagine a rope, wrap it around the curve, and when releasing the rope with keeping it pulled tight, then the tip of the rope will trace the involute curve. The concepts of involute and evolute are counteractive, meaning if curve A is the involute of curve B, it can be said that the curve B is the involute of the curve A, and vice versa. The example shown here for involute and evolute are curves which can be represented by equations in any coordinate system. While for the common case, finding the involute and evolute of a given curve is a difficult issue. Here, we can use the numerical simulation for simplifying the generation of these curves. You can see the MATLAB code software for generating the involute and evolute of any given curve numerically, depending on the shown definition of them. So, the design process of non-circular gears can be explained briefly as finding the pitch curves of the machine gears as the first step, and then generating the teeth profile on each pitch curve to satisfy the meshing and the pure rolling of the gear set as the second step. For the first step, the generation of the pitch curves depends basically on the equations shown in this video previously. This step can be completed either by using the given equations of the pitch curves, for example like elliptical gears, or by using the numerical simulation when there are no equations describe the pitch curves. While the second step, generating the teeth on each centroid, can be explained by the following sub-steps: dividing the centroid into equal segments in length as the centroids roll over each other with no slipping, which means each tooth covers the same length, which equals to the half of the circular pitch. Then, the boundaries of these equal segments on the centroids represents the points of the intersection between the centroid and the involute curves of the teeth. From these points, we can find the tangent points to the base curve, which from we can start the generation of the involute curves. The rest is trimming and combining the generated involute curves with trochoid curves as well as with the root and tip curves of the tooth. It should be mentioned that this methodology is valid just for convex gears, wherein a MATLAB code software was developed for this purpose. The outputs of the code software are the coordinates of the teeth points, which can be imported to SolidWorks or any other CAD software to generate the 3D module of the gear set. We can test the meshing in the machine study in SolidWorks to check if everything is okay or not. Also, the cheapest way for cutting non-circular gears is by laser or ERDM. Then the meshing can be tested practically on the manufacturer test rig, which was designed especially for this objective.